Good day, everybody. Welcome to our daily show, Santa Clarita Real Estate. I am Connor McIver, your host. Today, we're going to talk about Market Mondays. That's what we always get into on our Mondays during our seven-day-a-week real estate intel reports. So today, market updates, that kind of gives you an idea. We're going to have or give you access to the actual reports. Here in just a moment, you'll be able to go to our main site, paris911.com, and punch in the words market updates into the Mac box, and then you'll see each of the live reports that I have put together that we've gotten from the research company that we actually hire to do this information. Now, what you're going to see, a lot of things. You're going to see what the current median listing prices are. We're going to see how where we've come from in the last week. Also, you're going to get a good idea as to where real estate levels are and how long it's taking to sell residential real estate. And that's really important, especially if you are trying to base your buying or selling decision on something other than emotion. You definitely want to know what's going on in the market. Our seven-day recap is as follows. New listings in the Santa Clarita Valley, we have 120. 56 listings have had their prices changed in the last 7 days in Santa Clarita Valley cities. 37 properties have entered the back-on-market status. These are properties that didn't make it all the way to the finish line. They had tried, but something happened in the process where they didn't actually finish and conclude recording having new owners. Something to look at. If you want to see those properties, you can go to the Mac box at paris911.com and you can punch in the letters BOM for back on market, and you'll see all of those that happen to have fallen from escrow. Same thing with price changes. If you want to see the properties that have had their prices changes to get an indication, can't wait till Friday because we do that show. If you want to back up on paris911.com, you can see last Friday's show and get an idea. But if you want to see those price changes, which ones those are, just punch the words price changes into the Mac box at paris911.com. Same thing for the new listings. You want to see the new, punch in the word new and you'll get it. 68 properties entered escrow, 8 properties expired within their contractual time frames, not selling. 57 properties went pending, so they went into escrow in a pending status, which typically, if done correctly, those properties aren't showing up anymore as live and active. And then, of course, sold 49. So we have 49 real estate residential listing that closed in the past 7 days. Now, as far as real estate goes, a lot of information on the wire about the spring kickoff in real estate, and that actually is factual. If you look at every year, the numbers of homes that are on the market start to increase slowly, and it's very simply people are getting ready to move. So it's kind of a spring cleaning, if you will, not only with regard to their own residence, but maybe to move up to something bigger. Maybe they're trying to downsize. Maybe they're empty nesters. They have kids that are now off at school and they're looking around at this, you know, gargantuan 4,000 square foot house and they're thinking to themselves, gosh, should we be here or should we get something smaller? So these are things to look at when you're looking at a real estate market, and we do keep tabs on that information. You can very simply just tune into the radio show and we'll have it there. But that's what we're seeing. So with these 120 new listings, usually for the last, not usually, for the past several months, we've been seeing numbers in the 50s and 60s as far as new listings coming onto the market in a seven-day period. 120 is kind of breaking the rule. So now we're even higher in that. And I would opine that we're going to see that happen through the next few months. In addition to that, the buyer activity in Santa Clarita Valley is also going to start to increase as well. And it's already at a pretty high level. It's already up there. We're showing quite a few buyers and just watching that activity of properties going into escrow. So let's talk about Valencia for just a moment for our market update. This week, we're watching and monitoring Valencia, California, as we do the rest of the cities. You want to see what's going on in Valencia, you can punch in the word Valencia into the Mac box at paris911.com. You'll see all the active listings and other things as well. Good real estate intel. But this week, the median list price in Valencia, California is $577,500. there are 80 properties that have been on the market for an average of 87 days. Now, as we're watching, we see that inventory has been lightening lately, and the market action index has been trending up. These are mildly positive indications for the Valencia market. Now, market action index, that's something that people are curious about, and what it does is it answers the question of how's the market. It measures the current rate of sale versus the amount of the inventory. So if you have an index above 30, it's going to imply it's a seller's market, and below 30, you're going to see that it's a buyer's market. 47.3 is where we are, so we're still very well deep in a seller's market. Looking at supply and demand in Valencia, while the market action index shows some strengthening in the last few weeks, prices have not seemed to move from the plateau that they're currently at. Should the upward trend in sales relative to inventory continue, then we could expect prices to resume an upward climb in tandem with the MAI. The only thing that's going to break that is if we get more inventory and have the same level of buyer activity today. After a while, what's going to happen is they're going to have more to choose from, and the sellers aren't going to be able to demand as much for their properties. Quartile prices here in Santa Clarita Valley. Whenever we're doing our market action updates, we're looking at the real estate data on Mondays. It's a concern of ours, or at least a focus of ours, I should say, to look at the four different areas with regard to prices. So we break them up into quartiles. We have the first top 25%, second upper 25%, third lower, and fourth bottom. And you can see that information on our charts that we upload there by punching in the words market updates into the Mac box. You'll be able to see those. As far as price per square foot, we are watching that metric as well. And this is a market we're watching, like price per square foot, can provide insight that you don't get at first glance. Home prices are rising a bit recently, and the price per square foot of homes listed is declining a bit. Often this can be attributed to new and remodeled homes on the market. Buyers in the area are paying more, but getting more for their money. As far as inventory goes here in Valencia, it has been falling in recent weeks. Note that declining inventory alone does not signal a strengthening market. And again, continue to watch that market action index. Let's get into Stevenson Ranch so we can get an idea as to where that market is as well. So this particular week in Stevenson Ranch, median list price is $785,000. We have been monitoring 32 properties that have been on the market an average of 101 days. In Stevenson Ranch, we have a double arrow increase in asking price per square foot up to $282 a foot. We do see days on market time frames have reduced just a little, and we do have more inventory there at 32. But again, that's not a bunch for Stevenson Ranch, which has literally thousands and thousands of homes. 32 on the market for sale currently is pretty poor. Keep watching, though. We will keep reporting on the daily activity within the market. We will have the reports broken down for Canyon Country, Castaic, Newhall, and Saugus, of course, with Stevenson Ranch in Valencia. They will be uploaded and updated into the system, so you'll be able to go and look at those by punching in the words market updates into the Mac box at the top part of Paris911.com. Coming up tomorrow, our Travel Tuesdays broadcast, we'll talk about online resources. Probably the big one that we're going to hit tomorrow is going to be discussing how you find the HUD-approved complexes. A lot of people have that question because there's really no conclusive list, and the list changes if there were to be. So I'll give you that resource tomorrow so you can see what condos, townhomes, complexes are HUD approved and get an idea. That'll be what we'll do on a Travel Tuesdays broadcast. And of course, with always, we'll talk about the latest in real estate news, local inventory, and other resources that you can use to make your home buying and selling a lot more pleasurable. Everybody be safe. Thank you so much. We'll see you tomorrow during our Travel Tuesdays broadcast. I'm Connor McIver. Let us know if you need anything at all. We are on the job. Be safe. We'll talk to you soon.